So let's say you have a family or you are in a relationship and you want to create a list that you can share together. Well, Apple Reminders does this remarkably well. Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple. My name is Carl Pullin, and in this week's episode, I'm going to show you how to use Apple's Reminders app, their new Reminders app, to share lists with friends, partners, husbands, wives, girlfriends, boyfriends, whatever. Now, the beauty of this, and this is something I use actually every single day, is you can share something like a shopping list with your partner, so that if you're at work, as I am doing right now, I'm working, and my wife is at the supermarket, which she could very well be, then she doesn't have to call me, she doesn't have to message me, she can see it from the list. And likewise, the same can apply when I'm at the supermarket or I'm doing errands and I'm going past the hardware store. Either way, I can just check the list and see if there's anything that's on the list that either my wife or I have put on there. And that's what I'm going to show you how to do today. Basically, I'm going to show you how to share a list. Now, if you do get any value from this episode, then I would be most grateful if you would help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips and tricks about building your very own Apple productivity system, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my reminders, my real reminders, on my real iPhone and show you how to set this up. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to open up my Reminders app right now, and you'll see that I have a couple of lists here, one of which is a family list, which I'm just going to move up to underneath my shopping, my routines. It's just something, as I've covered before in previous episodes. So all you need to do to actually share a shopping list, and as I say, this is something that I find incredibly useful, because you know, sometimes my wife, as she is at the moment, she could be out shopping while I'm doing some work, and she, rather than having to call me and say, do you want anything from the pharmacy or do you need anything from the supermarket, all she has to do is access this list because it's shared. Now at the moment it's not shared because I want to show you how to do this. So all you do is you click on shopping. Now as you can see in here, I've got some very healthy ingredients, some balsamic vinegar, some virgin olive oil, apple cider vinegar and multivitamins. Now, really quite easy to share a list like this is you go to the three dots on the top right up there, and you can change a few things in here. You can add name and appearance, add people, delete list, select reminders, show completed. So I'm going to add people, and it's going to ask me, how do I want to share this list? So for me, because my wife is using an iPhone, so I can just do this via messages. So I can click on that. It's going to say, okay, who do you want to do it to? So I can type in my wife's name, tap that, and I can just send that off. So there we go, bang, off it goes. And now she has this list. So it's now shared with my wife. Now I can do the same thing by going back here, and I can hit the family list, and I can do again, there's nothing in there, but I can add people, and I can go back to here, messages. I'm going to do it via messaging, and I can do again, type in my wife's name, and let me just try it. Something's going wrong here. It's not doing what I want it to do, but let me just share this. And it's come up with, it's come up with my wife's name in this case. So you can see this telling me who it is shared with underneath. Now, I've opaqued it out for the moment, but underneath you will see that it is actually showing up that I've shared this list with that particular person. And you'll always get that. Now, let's just say that you decide that you don't want to share this list. So all you have to do is, again, is go into the three dots and view participants. And you can just tap on stop sharing, which I will do. Okay, I've stopped sharing that, and my wife's name has disappeared. And I can go into this one, and I can do, and I can say this, view participants, and again, stop sharing. And that now is not being shared. So you can do this with any people that you like. Obviously, in my case, I have a reason why we can share the shopping list with my wife, which is obviously very logical. Or I could create, like as we've got here, a family list, which we used on a recent trip to Europe, because there were things that we needed to buy while we're in Europe before we came back to Korea. So there you go. That's just a quick, simple way of using your reminders app outside of any other productivity apps that you may have. And this is really good, particularly if you, your friends, your partner, whoever it is that you want to share a list with, is in your own, you know, using an iOS device or has access to an Apple computer. Of course, they can do it through iCloud, but I usually find if they're using an iOS device such as a phone, then obviously it's so much easier. So there you go. Hopefully you found this useful. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my learning center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, reminders, and calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.